All right, so we've brought a nuke from one bee yard to a smaller bee yard here. We're going to take that nuke and we're going to populate this top bar hive right here. So we're going to open it up and get the bees into their new home. So when we transport bees, we put them in a nuke box, a smaller box, and then we cover them with some mesh so they have good ventilation. The trip wasn't very far. It was only about two kilometers from one bee yard to the next. So not too small, not too far.
So no bees came in our car.
Nope. They were well packaged.
I kept my veil on just in case.
Well packaged up. And there's a few hanging on there. So we'll just set those there for now. And then we're just going to slowly take them and put them in their new home. So this is a nice bar full of nectar. We're in a huge honey flow right now, or nectar flow, so there's a lot of nectar and they are just packing this. And the smell, I wish you could smell how sweet and floral this smells. It's incredible. Absolutely incredible.
You see all the shiny stuff there? That's the nectar.
That's nectar.
Get us some honey.
That was all, there was no brood in there, right?
Nope.
On that one? Okay. So when you put the smaller colony or the nucleus colony into a larger hive, you want to try to keep the same order that the bees have built. So typically they have food on either side, and then in the middle is where they have their brood, or their unhatched bees, or larvae, or egg, or whatever. I'm not too worried about finding the queen, because this nuke was checked just the other day, and we did spot the queen, and we could see some egg and cat brood, so we're not worried about seeing the queen. Although if we do, it's a bonus.
Lots
I'm seeing
brood.
Cat brood on this side.
Totally,
what do you see there?
Totally cat brood.
Yep. Wonderful. So we'll take a little bit of time just to see if I can spot the queen. It's always nice if you can. But you can see solid laying. This queen, brand new queen, just under, been laying maybe for 2 weeks now, and she is just really laying solid pattern. I'll just look this way, see if I can see the queen on the sides there. You do see some honey dripping. There is so much nectar right now, they're just packing it in. So I don't see the queen here. I do see some older bees, like some of these bees that are darker in color, like this one right here, and one right there. Those are older bees. The newer bees tend to have a little bit of fuzz. They have more color, and then as they age and they're out flying around, they start to lose that fuzz, which then takes away their colors. So there's some older bees in here. But there's definitely newer bees as well. We see some drones. So the drone are the male bees, so right here. Mm-hmm. And they're bigger. So that's a male bee right there. And the male bees have no stingers, so they don't sting. And you can see we have different colors. So here's another drone. So right there, this is a male bee, and you can see nice and orange and black. Yet the drone that we were looking at before is darker in color. Just genetics, of course. So I don't see the queen on this one. We'll flip it back over. Let's take another quick look here, just in case she's there. And I don't see her. Let's put her in. And again, as we take the bars out, of course, you want to be able to take as many bees with those bars as possible. And if you can spot that queen, that's great, because you always want to protect that queen. But if by chance, she's still in the box, of course we gently shake that box of bees into their new hive. But again, always better if we can find her first, just so that we know she's safe. So I'll let you take a look there, see if we see the queen anywhere. The best way to look at comb, of course, is to have the sun at your back. So that's why I'm turning this way, so the sun is now at my back, so I can see a little bit better. just move some of the bees, and I can see inside here there's lots of egg and there's little larvae in there. So that's good. So that means that some of these bees had already hatched out and she's relaid in that space, which is great. That's what you want her to do. So again, have another gander, have another look. Not seeing her on this side. And again, with so many bees, we may not even spot her, but of course we'll take a little bit of time to see if we can find her. Just because we got to shake the bees in there, and prefer not to shake her in there if it's possible. Not seeing her there either. Bees look good, they look happy. Okay, put that one in. Two more to go. And there's a lot of bees in there.
I see her.
You see the queen?
Yep.
Great. So seeing that queen, again, helps to protect her. That way we don't have to shake her in there, because we will shake the remaining bees that are in the box inside the hive. So Gloria is able to see her. I can't see her from this angle, but that's okay. If Gloria sees her, that's good. Yeah, there she is. Wow, what a pretty color. She's like a caramel color. And she's not a very big queen. And, you know, when you're looking for the queen, you always want to see that nice, big, long, and kind of plump queen. And, you know, you consider that to be a sign of a really healthy queen that's going to lay a lot of eggs. But that's not necessarily true. This is a smaller queen. She is laying in a very, very solid pattern, meaning that she is using every single cell to put an egg in. And that's what we've been seeing with this queen. So even though she's a little bit smaller, she is laying like a champion. So that's what we want to see. That makes that hive just really ramp up really quickly. And that's what we're looking for, because there is a big honey flow right now, or nectar flow, meaning that in nature, there's a lot of nectar in the plants, in the flowers. So they are sourcing all of that and bringing it back to the hive. And that's what they use to make honey. So that's shiny, of course. And look over here, Gloria. Can you see that dripping? See? Right there.
Yep.
That's nectar. So the nectar, of course, is a little bit more watery than honey would be. So once they put that in there, they fan that nectar, and then it reduces the water content and it becomes thicker. And then once it's the consistency that they like, they cap it. And we can see, is there some capped up
top
here?
Yeah.
So we'll see right in here, this is capped honey right here. So the consistency is what they're looking for, and they've capped it. If I just, you know, just make a small little indent there, you start to see the honey come out. Of course, they'll clean that right up, and there they go. Pretty neat. I wish you could smell it. It smells so sweet and like flowers, really, really strong. We'll just take a look inside there. Well, let's see if we can get a shot inside there. You can see some egg. It looks like a little small piece of rice in there. That would be an egg. Really hard to see, so I'm not sure if the camera's picking it up.
Just trying to get an angle here.
And of course, I'm starting to shake now, but...
Yeah, no, I'm not. It's hard to see on the camera.
With one hand, I'm going to have to go and grab it with the other arm there. So very hard to see. Anyhow, she's doing great. So here we can see, like, right... So up top here, this is capped honey. So they will cap that with wax. Here is capped brood. So this is unhatched bees. So right here, it looks a little more fuzzy. Then all of these empty holes, or cells rather, are bees that have already hatched out. The queen has found it, has laid another egg, and of course that egg will turn into a larvae, and then they'll feed it. They continue to feed it, and then they cap it. Then of course the bee hatches out, and the cycle just keeps going that way. they'll often put food up top here, even though this we would call the brood or the brood nest. They'll put food here so they have quick access to be able to feed. Pretty remarkable. Okay, we're gonna put them in. And so you can see also that the bees are fairly docile, right? They do sting, and that's how they protect themselves, protect their colony, protect their queen, protect their hive. But they're very docile. So as long as they have good food and things are going well in the hive, they're pretty docile. They're pretty calm. And tonight, of course, as the sun starts to set, they're all coming back home. So they want to get in there and they want to get all snug in their hive for the night. So thanks for watching.